Hello, I'm Dr. Alex Popovich. I'm a breast cancer surgeon as well as menopause specialist. Today we're going to talk about a topic that's very important but also misunderstood, which is breast density. What it means for your breast cancer risk, how it affects the way we screen for and detect breast cancer. Whether you're a woman with breast cancer or you know someone with a breast cancer, or simply you're interested in finding and learning more about women's health, this information is important for making better informed decisions about breast screening. What breast density means is basically having more working or fibroglandular breast tissue in the breast. So often the breast tissue is made out of the fatty tissue and fibroglandular tissue. And together, the combination of that makes the breast density. The difficult bit is that the denser breast, it ends up being more white on a mammogram, and cancer is also white on a mammogram. So cancer is much easier to hide within that lighter tissue. On the mammogram, fatty tissue is black. So white cancer can be really easily seen against the black of the fatty breast tissue. So basically, breast density makes it harder to see cancers on a mammogram. So breast density is graded A to D. It's either called BI-RADS, A, B, C, D, or Volpara. Type A is almost entirely fatty breast tissue. You can see here on this mammogram that there is actually a very little whiteness, and you can see pretty much really well through this breast tissue. And on a mammogram, you always get at least two views. The one on the left, it's called the CC view, and then you have lateral projection of view, which is the one on the right. And even on this one, you can see that the breast has quite a lot of blackness to this. So this is density A. If we look at density grade B, you can see here on the CC view, which is the left one again, that there is more white tissue. And same on that side view, there is a more whiter tissue in the middle. You can still pretty well see through this mammogram. You might say, am I missing something really small? So in this case, we would possibly look at something like a 3D mammogram. So this one's more the C density. You can see it's a bit more whiter in the both CC projection as well as on the lateral projection in the mammogram. So it's much easier to hide things. So this person would benefit from 3D mammogram, probably more so, and we could consider something like a contrast mammogram. And we'll talk more about the imaging shortly. Now, we'll look at the density D. So this is really dense breast tissue. You can see that there's much more denser and whiter breast tissue. It's harder to see through that breast tissue and much more easy for something to hide in this area. So this woman would benefit more from a contrast or from an MRI as well as the mammogram. So if we go back to grade, so grade one is almost entirely fatty, has less than 25% of fibroglandular tissue. Grade B density, scattered fibroglandular density is 25 to 50. Then heterogeneous dense, there's that C or 3. And then extremely dense is more than 75% glandular tissue. 40 to 50% of women have dense breast tissue. The younger you are, the more likely it is that you're going to have denser breast tissue because our hormones work on breast tissue through our cycle. The breast tissue reacts to that and it becomes more dense. Similar thing happens on HRT. Women who are slim often have a higher density breast tissue. But why is that important? There are actually two reasons why this is important. One, women who have a denser breast tissue do have a higher risk of breast cancer. But this is where it's important to know what their risk was to start with. So if they don't have any family history, they don't have any other risk factors, the risk is around, every woman's risk for breast cancer is around 12%, which is really high. So doubling that could be up to 20, 24%. The other reason why it actually matters is that we in denser breast tissues cannot see cancers as well because they tend to hide. So smaller cancers are easier to hide. But don't get too worried about having denser breast tissue. It doesn't mean you will get breast cancer. It just means that we need to figure out what's your best screening tool. The other important thing is that even if you do develop breast cancer, if you have a breast denser tissue, your risk of dying from breast cancer is not higher than someone who has a low density breast tissue. So this masking effect is a challenge. And we know that screening mammography is not as effective in women who have dense breast tissue. What is important is that you ask about your breast density when you have your mammogram, so you know whether the mammogram is the right tool for you or whether you need a better tool for screening. Now, in New Zealand, screening mammograms are only 2D or 4 images. That is still a really good breast screening option. It detects 70 to 80% of all breast cancers. But that does drop down to 50% if you have a really dense breast tissue. Now, 3D mammograms are basically mammograms where they've taken some extra pictures so radiologists or programs can reconstruct a 3D image of the breast tissue. And we use those to see, does the part of the breast pull different way? Can we see, notice the breast cancers in the denser breast tissue? And a lot of studies have been done of this. And yes, if you do have higher breast density, especially higher B or C density, then you would definitely benefit from 3D mammogram. Unfortunately, in New Zealand, you can't get 3D mammogram routinely as a part of the breast screening. But if they see something on a 2D mammograms, you will be recalled for a 3D mammograms and ultrasound. Now, ultrasound is another tool. It's much more difficult one to do. It requires a lot of knowledge how to interpret it. It's basically sound waves traveling through the breast tissue. You can see here on the first picture that this is much more denser breast tissue. It's that white stuff. And it's also even on an ultrasound much harder to see through. Now we have the second one, which shows us a lump, which is very likely to be benign from their characteristics. And in this case, it was, with fattier breast tissue and slightly denser breast tissue, which is the whiter breast tissue. So you can see things in the ultrasound well. So if radiologists notice something on the mammogram, you'll definitely need to have ultrasound as well on top of the mammogram. The next investigation, it's called magnetic resonance imaging. And it's a very good imaging for breast, but it is quite expensive. When we compare the cost, 3D mammogram costs around $480 or something like that. MRI is around $2,500. It's thousands of images. You have to be really well trained to read breast MRIs. And they look a bit like this. You have to have a certain dye, it's called gadolinium, to see whether there is a part of breast that enhances differently to the other side. Could there be a cancer or not? It is very sensitive investigation. It will find a lot of cancers. But MRI is also not so specific for a cancer, which means we are more likely to detect other things as well, like a fibrocystic breast, which needs to be investigated or biopsied or followed up. Now, that causes quite a lot of anxiety for women who have to go through these investigations. It is used a lot in women with a very high-risk family history. So someone like Angelina Jolie, who has a really high family history risk, her screening would always include MRI. The new kid on the block is something called contrast-enhanced mammogram. In Wellington, we're the first one so far in the country to have it. It's iodine-based dye that gets absorbed by cancers a bit more. It's similar to MRI, but it's much cheaper. So the cost of that is around $680 or $700. This is the contrast mammogram. You can see on the left side, It's a very dense breast tissue. This woman has had previous surgery, so we've left some clips in there. You can't see through this whiteness of her background breast tissue. The picture on the right is subtraction image from the contrast. You can see that there is no increase in enhancement anywhere in this breast. So she does not have cancers hiding in that whiteness. Recent studies have shown that it can find 3 times more invasive cancers in dense breast tissue than ultrasound. And it can spot smaller tumors than regular mammogram, even the 3D mammogram. The problem is it's not widely available. As said, in New Zealand, Wellington is the only place that has it, but I'm sure it's going to become available very quickly. So what does that mean for you? It just means that your screening should be personalized to your own risk profile. If you don't have dense breast tissue, you're fine with normal mammograms, and they're the best ones for you with the least amount of risks. If you have dense breast tissue, you should talk to your doctor about getting something like a contrast mammogram or MRI or ultrasound, depending where you live. This also depends on what your background risk factor is. So if you have BRCA-like family history or you have a gene, then you should be screened more often and definitely with MRI. To summarize, if you do have high breast density, then you are of higher risk of developing breast cancer, and your mammograms have more difficulty in spotting it. Mammography is essential. We have to do it because even on some of the other imaging, you may not detect low-grade DCIS, but mammography may not be enough for women who have high density. If you are one of these women, ask your doctor whether you'd be candidate for contrast, enhanced mammogram, MRI, or the ultrasound, and what the costs of that are. Early detection saves lives. Understanding your breast density and choosing the right screening tool is a powerful step that you can take in protecting your health. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you'd like me to talk about any other topics on breast cancer or menopause, please put it in the comments below and I will make future videos on that topic. Bye for now.